Greetings to everyone. Hope everyone is in pink of their health. This side Suyas Tripathi. I'm a second year student pursuing BLLB honors from MIT Law School, Gwalior, Madhya Pradesh. And currently I am working as a legal intern with Lexis & Company. So today we are going to discuss on the topic elements of crime. So before moving to the topic, I would like to define crime. The task of defining crime is not easy. The task of defining crime is not easy. There have been a struggle by many jurists to define the crime, but they were unable to some extent to define the crime. The Russell, a famous jurist, has said that the task of defining crime has so far not been satisfactorily accomplished. The crime has not been defined yet satisfactorily. But I will give you an overview that what the crime means. So a crime is an act or omission for which a legal punishment is inflicted on the person. Who is in default for committing that act or omission. So IPC deals with the punishments and crimes. IPC, Indian Penal Code 1860, deals with crimes and punishment. So now we'll move towards our topic, that is elements of crime. So there are four elements of crime. What are they? They are first is human body, second is mens rea, third is actus reus, and the fourth one is injury. So the first element of crime, that is human body. So it seems like a joke that in ancient times animals were also punished for the thing which was considered as a crime. Yeah, it was a reality, but it seems like a joke in today's world. There was an instance, I was reading a book and I came to know that a horse was hanged just for kicking a man. The cattle were imprisoned as they were found to be guilty of the crime of trespass. So it seems like a joke today in today's world, but it's not. So but now in today's world, only human beings are punished for the crime they do. Animals are exempted from the liabilities of crime. Now we'll move towards the second topic. Second element of crime, that is mens rea. So mens rea, what does the term mens rea mean? Mens rea means guilty mind. So I will give you a Latin maxim, that is actus facit non reum mens rea. That means actus non facit reum nisi mens rea. This is the Latin maxim. This means that guilty mind and guilty act together forms a crime. There can be no crime without a guilty mind, but there's an exemption also, that is the crime of strict liability, that the strict liability has been exempted, that if you have committed any act which is under the provision of strict liability, which is under the criteria of strict liability, then you will then even without having any guilty intention or without having any guilty thoughts in your mind for committing that crime, you will be punished. What is this strict liability? The principle of strict liability was given in the case of M.C. Mehta versus Union of India. You must read that for having more knowledge in this topic. Then the third element of crime is actus reus, that is act. That without that, if you have any, for example, you have an intention to kill a man, but you have not manifested it in the external world. That is, you have not killed him. You just have an intention. You can't be punished. So an act has to be committed. So what is actus reus? Actus reus is the manifestation of the thoughts in the external world. And the fourth element of the crime is injury. That is, that act should result in the injury. So that's all for today. I have defined the elements of crime, and for strict liability, if you want to learn about the strict liability, please do comment in the comment box. I will make another video for the strict liability, and don't forget to click the bell icon to get the further updates, and please click on the subscription button. Thank you.